what we can do. 20.2 is and solid rod 30 corresponding to the amount plus polyandrene in present in the material. So it shows the nitrogen certain distortion of the material. From the figure we can see a H1 hysterical loop for starting as relative pressure at 0.2, and the figures the material shows the pore size of 2.4, 2.7 and 3.4 for body trimethylene, monoclase and carotene sample. This figure shows the HTR spectra. From the figure you can see the peak at 1572 and 1496 corresponding to the quinoid and bentonoid unit present in the material confirm the presence of polyandrene unit in the cyclanethanol. This shows the thermogram for the material and two wave loads, one at 100 degree Celsius and the second one is 350 degree Celsius. After calcination, the second wave load is at the 550 degree Celsius. This figure shows the cyclic voltagram for the electrochemical polymerization of 50 millimolar trimethylsilyl propanolidine in 1 molar naphthalene sulfonic acid. It shows two anodic waves and two cathodic waves. It confirms the formation of feeding foam capacity of this monomer in ITO. This for analytic application, I have prepared two sensors. One is for glucose, one is for cholesterol sensor. I have used bi-enzyme, one is HRP, host peroxidase, and glucose oxidase, and host peroxidase and cholesterol oxidase with my polymer. For this sensor application, the main aim is to detect the amount of hydrogen peroxide formed as the byproduct of the material. So I studied as the preliminary step for the reduction of hydrogen peroxide using the polytrimethylsilyl propanolidine with the host peroxidase. The figure shows the engine speed at minus 150 millivolt with increase in the concentration of hydrogen peroxide, shows a linear increase in the current, shows the high sensing capability of this electrode towards the hydrogen peroxide. When comparing with other electrodes like lactic carbon, indium tin oxide, or the sustained monomer, this electrode shows enhanced current in compared to other electrodes. This slide shows the effect of thickness, enzyme loading, temperature, and pH. As the thickness of the material increases, the HRP loading also increases linearly up to 4 micrometer. Then there is no much increase in the enzyme loading, so we have this at the